And we kick it off with Craig Williams. Will, I appreciate your time on the day before the Melbourne Cup. It's such a busy period for all jockeys. For those who haven't experienced it, can you put into words what that moment was like when you won on Vow and Declare?
Well, it is clearly life-changing for a rider. And even though I've been brought up in a racing family, at school I wrote stories that I've already won the Cup multiple times and dreamt of being a jockey and winning the Melbourne Cup. But even though it is our race that stops our nation, it's now a international targeted race from everyone else that wants a part of it. And after being lucky enough to win it 2 years ago on Vow and Declare, it is clearly a life-changing race. So I feel really honoured to be on the list, and I want to get that feeling again this year with Spanish Mission.
It's your 19th ride in a Melbourne Cup tomorrow, which is quite incredible. And 9 jockeys are having their first ride in a Melbourne Cup tomorrow. Can you remember back to when you had your first big ride in a Cup and what the anticipation, the nervousness was like?
I remember being really excited, which I still am going into tomorrow's race. But and I remember being in a really good position at the top of the straight, and then realised at that level, at that distance, that sometimes that was probably a little bit far too early for my horse in that year. So through experience, I've learnt a lot of different scenarios, and most importantly, what type of horse it does take to win the race. But very, very fortunate. It is a game of inches, and especially this race is it's a handicap over 2 miles, and they are horses from all over the world, trained, ridden, and it truly is a remarkable race every year.
Well, you may well have the right horse tomorrow, Spanish Mission. You went down to Werribee, you had a ride on him yesterday. What kind of impact did he give you? What kind of feel did he give you?
I was really excited. With everything in the media and all the reports that he, well, not the reports, but the fact that he failed two vet checks before he could be accepted to be passed fit and healthy to race. And but after sitting on his back yesterday, I have no concerns. He's a lovely horse. He's a beautiful horse to do anything with for a rider. He's in really good order. He's got lovely action. He feels like he's got good change-up speed as well, which will be really helpful in tomorrow's race. And I'm really looking forward to the challenge with him. He's been he's been set for this race, like every horse in the race. But they're very bullish about his chances, and I can understand why after having my first sit on him yesterday.
Is Incentivise the obvious one that you have to beat, Craig?
Yeah, absolutely. But I still think there's a couple of lightweight horses in the race that are going to have 7 kilos less than myself and Incentivise, or 6 or maybe 5 kilos with Kieran McAvoy's horse. But again, it's going to be a great race. The weather is going to be really hot, so horses are going to have to handle the day. Mm-hmm. And one thing that's great for us as entertainers, for us jockeys on course, we've got crowds back. So it's and it's been quite unusual for horses in the last 18 months in Australia to be lucky enough to be racing through this pandemic, but to actually have noise and crowds and emotion at the races. So I think a lot of it's going to be a big benefit for horses if they can handle the day and the heat on leading into the race.
Craig, you've been there and done it before. We wish you all the best tomorrow.
Yeah, I was just going to ask Craig about the impact of crowds. You mentioned what that might have on the horses and the jockeys. I mean, what does the return of crowds mean for both jockeys and horses, particularly on a warm day?
Well, for horses, there's no doubt that there's going to be extra noise around, which they have been used to for the last 18 months. And for jockeys, if you're victorious at Flemington coming down that race, there's nothing better. We love to entertain. We love people being on course. And there's nothing better to come back when you're victorious to a great jovial crowd. But if you're getting beaten on favourites, that's the opposite end of the spectrum, where it's a long road coming back to that race if you're getting booed and hissed if you weren't successful in that race.
What is it about Incentivise that makes him so good?
I followed him into the race the other day in the Caulfield Cup, which is arguably our Australian best lead-up for the Melbourne Cup. And I felt that he was struggling around the bend, but once he straightened up, he just dropped me. And I felt straight after the race, I thought, if he gets there in the same healthy condition, then we won't beat him at Flemington. But Spanish Mission has got a form from a different angle, and that's what I'm banking on. And again, it is, as Kieran highlighted, and Jai, that it is also going out to 2 miles, and at this quality even though he's got to carry the penalty of winning the Caulfield Cup and the Turnbull, and Farlap was the only horse that's able to do it. So he is going to try and break history. But if there is a year that looks like that history can be made in regards to probably the lack of depth in opposition, this is definitely that year.
Craig, Braden from Nine, when you've won a Melbourne Cup like you have and waited so long for it, when you go to the race now, do you not feel the pressure? Do you almost go there without any burden and you can just enjoy the race for what it is, obviously wanting to win it?
I think it's just because it's one race we have that really is the highlight of our whole fixture. It's our grand final. It's what we all work for. It's what we all dreamed of as jockeys, wanting to be winning. So there is only one chance at it. So there is a lot of expectations. There's a lot of energy put towards it. But if you don't have the horse, then because we know what it takes, that type of horse to win the race, then if you haven't got a chance, then you're really not going to put yourself under too much pressure. But after riding my horse yesterday at Werribee, I've got really excited, and I just can't wait for that race tomorrow at Flemington.